I felt sad and I felt scared when I found out that I had been exposed to COVID-19. I was afraid that I had exposed my family and my coworkers, and I was afraid of what was going to happen to me.
My name is Jay Corpening. I serve as the Chief District Court Judge for New Hanover and Pender Counties. I'm also serving as the co-chair of the Chief Justice's COVID-19 Task Force. Everyone is experiencing trauma as part of this pandemic. Everyone's trauma is real, and it's personal to them.
During this pandemic, I worry about our courts and our families and our communities. When I get down on myself, I think about the fact that we really will be stronger and better on the other side of this pandemic.
Every time I go to work, I think about my family. I think about risks, who I come across, what I touch, washing hands. That's always in the back of my mind now.
I, like many of you, feel anxious when I go to work on the front lines of this pandemic. I wonder often if today's the day I become a statistic and don't even know it until later on.
I feel anxious when I think of the families who don't have incomes coming in right now. My hope for the future is that we've learned what wasn't good for our souls and we cherish our time together.
It scares me when I think about not being able to go out in public without worrying about other people's health. I have seen great positivity in the way that our community has come together. Everyone is pitching in and trying to help people that need it.
The thing that I've missed most during this pandemic is being able to go out across the state to meet and to see you. I feel that we do our work best at the AOC when we have an appreciation and an understanding of how you do your work in your offices.
I, like many of you, feel anxiety when I'm constantly bombarded with news reports, internet articles, emails, and text messages regarding the coronavirus. One of the ways my family and I fight this anxiety is through our evening walks. It allows us to decompress, and more importantly, unplug, while enjoying each other's company and the great outdoors.
Some of the hardest things about the coronavirus has been the abrupt stop to what we know as business as usual. It's hard to do what we do when we're concerned about speaking with others face to face and preferring that nobody come into our office.
I feel anxious about returning to the courtroom. In most of the courtrooms that I work, my desk is catty-cornered between the attorneys and the judge, and being a bit of a germaphobe, as the inmates walk in, the other court staff, am I going to be holding my breath? Probably.
This experience has really taught me to slow down and helped me to appreciate my blessings. Please remember, you are not in this alone.
It scares me when I think about the detrimental impact COVID-19 has had in our communities. On a positive note, I've witnessed an increased use of technology in our courts, as well as support among court personnel and the legal community in response to the pandemic.
The biggest challenge our office faces during COVID-19 is that we want to be together and achieve justice for our victims. But the stressful part of it is we want to do this in a safe environment for both our staff and the public. During this time, we're just going to have to be patient and compassionate with one another. We wish everyone a safe and healthy return.
We're changing things in the courthouse that we probably should have looked at a long time ago. You're not alone. We're all going to get through this. Just stay strong. Take care of yourselves. Take care of your family. God bless.
And I would encourage you to do the same, to lean on your coworkers and lean on your judicial partners. We're all in this together, and together we can make it through. We're going to come out even stronger than we've ever been before.
In this pandemic, it has brought us back to what's important, valuable time with our loved ones. You are not alone. We wish everyone a safe and healthy return.
My hope for the future is that this time of where everything seems to be up in the air, that we all come out of it more grateful, more appreciative of our family and our friends and our colleagues and all of the relationships that really keep us motivated to move forward on a daily basis.
I keep wondering when things will return to normal, and I hope that when it does, we all stay safe and we are able to help those who have been most affected by this pandemic.
Members of the judicial branch across the state have worked tirelessly to ensure continuous operations during these unprecedented times. We wish everyone a safe and healthy return.
I just want to say continued good health and well-being to all of you. I hope to see you soon.
You are not alone. There is help out there. Please don't be afraid to seek that help. I hope everyone has a safe and healthy return.
Never before have we experienced anything like this. It is more important than ever before that we stand together, that we look out for each other, and that we take care of each other.
Take good care and stay safe. See you soon.
We wish everyone a safe and healthy return.